Hello and welcome to this video tutorial from Computergaga.com. And in this video, we are going to cover two simple ways of working with international number formats. So in this example, here in the UK, we use a decimal point as a separator, where many other countries in the world will use a decimal comma. So when we're working with numbers received from such countries, there can be some confusion in Excel. Now there's multiple ways of handling this, including setting up default settings in Excel. But here I want to cover two very simple ways. So on screen, I have some pretend sales data from a store in Gdansk in Poland, and they use a decimal comma. So Excel does not understand what these numbers are. It's put them on the left, storing them as text. I need to convert them to numbers. I cannot sum or chart any of these values until that's done. So here comes simple example number one. And we can select column B, the column with the values, and open up the find and replace window of Excel, either by using the button on the home tab or the keyboard shortcut Control H. And with the replace window open, I can perform my first find and replace, where I will look for a full stop, because that has been used in two of them as a thousand separator. But once again, that confuses Excel, or my version of Excel, because it believes it to be a sentence and a full stop. And it's not necessary here, it's just to make it look easier to read. I'm going to replace it with nothing, and when I do that, out it goes. I'll click OK to the confirmation message, and with a second find and replace, instead of the full stop, I will look for the comma, so that's our decimal separator now, and replace it with a decimal point separator. And notice all those values are on the left hand side. When I click replace all, they are thrown to the right as Excel now recognizes them as numbers. I can now click OK, close down my window, and then format these further as appropriate and use them in further data analysis tasks. So that's our first example, simple example of working with an international number and being able to convert it quickly for use. And that's great if you've just got values coming in via spreadsheets in and you need to quickly change them, because that will just take you a few seconds. But what if it's a more regular occurrence? What if the values in this range were changed regularly? I don't want to keep having to run find and replace, however quick it might be. Or what if we need to perform multiple transformation tasks, not just converting number formats, but also removing duplicates or renaming column headers? Or what if the data is coming from an external source, like a CSV file or from a web page? Well, in examples like that, rather than the quick find and replace, we could use Power Query. So if I click somewhere in that range of values, and on the data tab, click from table range, but I could grab this data from other external sources immediately. It doesn't need to be in my spreadsheet. But let's imagine for a moment that this is how I receive the data. I'll click OK to open the Power Query Editor, where I can perform numerous tasks. To start with, we could rename the query on the right-hand side if the situation was more elaborate maybe than this. But just to focus on the purpose of this video, I need to convert these into numbers. Now I will start by selecting the column 2 here, my values column, and on the home tab, a replace values button. Where I'm going to do the same thing as we did initially with find and replace. I'm going to ask it to find that full stop and replace it with nothing, because that will still cause us problems when converting this. When I click OK, the full stop is removed and it is added as a step over on the right hand side. So for anybody who might be new to Power Query watching this and you're thinking, God, it was so much faster with the find and replace one, why would I go through all this? I've still got to convert them yet. But this will be better in a more elaborate solution where you have more transformations to do. So we can do them all here and refresh them with just one click of a button or get them from the external source directly. And I want to be clear on that because obviously the speed of this is not comparing to the previous tip at the moment. We now need to change the locale. So if I click on this ABC icon, which illustrates the number formatting, that it's still stored as text. And if I click on that, I have other options like currency, date and time, etc. But I want using locale. Here I can specify the origin of these values. I will choose currency, that's the type of number. This can be really useful when converting international dates as well though. And then for the locale, rather than scroll through this list, I'm going to type a P to jump to the P's. It's just off screen, and I can find Poland a little bit quicker than my scrolling. If I then click OK, they are happily converted into something that my Excel recognises. Now, this is not the formatting, it's a data type. Let's be clear on that. So just like with find and replace, I'll still need to format them as currency after. I'm just putting this into a recognisable data type. I now need to close and load this back to my worksheet. I can zoom out of this now. And then this will be refreshable in the future, nice and easily. If I just put this into a table in the existing worksheet for this demonstration. And here it comes and here it is. So in the future, if any of those numbers was to change, if product B, $43.99, was to become $500 and let's do $76, then I can either come to my queries and connections pane on the right or the data tab at the top, just refresh my data, and here is the update. So it would be quicker to update in the future than performing a find and replace sequence, and we could have done a lot more with that as well. So we've got two simple ways of working with international number formats there. No VBA, no complex Excel formulas, just good old find and replace, and then the fantastic Power Query solution. I hope you found this video useful. Please check out some of our other video tutorials on our YouTube channel and come check us out at computergaga.com.